Hello class, welcome to the next lecture on signals and systems. And in this lecture we'll be seeing the step-by-step procedure for how to do a convolution sum and integral both, and we will solve a problem for convolution integral. Okay, so what I'll do is I'll write them simultaneously. Okay, steps. So the basic idea is that we have to achieve convolution integral or convolution sum, right? So let me just write down what we want to achieve. So in this side we want to achieve I of t is equal to minus infinity to infinity x of tau h of t minus tau d tau. And in this side, we want to achieve y of n is equal to summation k equal to minus infinity to infinity x of k h of n minus k. Okay, so first step, what we do is we do the folding. So one thing I've maybe forgot to mention in the last class is that you can switch, that is, if this is the same as taking x of t minus tau h of tau, right? That is, this, if you interchange the shifting part, it is the same, right? Doesn't matter. Okay, so the first thing is we change the variable, independent variable, from t to tau, and here we change it from n to k. Okay, we change the independent variable. Then what do? We fold. Folding is taking the inverse of tau. So we either have x of minus tau or we have h of minus tau. Similarly, when we are folding here, what do we have? We have x of minus k or h of minus k. Okay. And the third part, third step, which is shifting. Right, shifting is we have x of t minus tau, and how do we get x of t minus tau? Actually, the process here is we take x of minus of t minus tau minus t, which becomes x of t minus tau. Okay, I hope you are clear regarding this. We are introducing the shift forward. Okay, and here we have h of t minus tau. The same concept is applicable here also, this part. Then similarly here we do the shifting. How do we do the shifting? We have x of n minus k h of n minus k. So here what you should observe is that the shift we are introducing, right, that term we are taking as the variable which is used as the independent variable for our output. Okay, that is why the earlier class I mentioned that the output is a function of the shift that we are using for the convolution integral or convolution sum. Okay, so here also that is applicable, x of minus of k minus n, which is x of n minus k. Then what is that? We have the multiplication part, which is we either have x of t minus tau h of tau, or we have x of tau h of t minus tau. And in this case, what do we have? Again, multiplication. We have x of, sorry, x of n minus k h of k, or we have x of k h of n minus k. And ultimately, the last step is integration. And here it is addition, summation. Okay. That's the reason why I didn't simply write down this integration formula here or summation formula here, because we have to consider the regions of both the signals, because once we multiply, some regions will have to be integrated with a certain limits, and other regions will have to be integrated using a certain limit, similarly for summation. So that is why I didn't write down the formula as such. That will you will understand once we solve a problem. Okay, so this much I hope you guys understood. Here we want to achieve, this is a step-by-step procedure for how to achieve a convolution integral or convolution sum. Basically, what first we change the variable of the functions, that is input function and the impulse response, then we fold the variable, either one, you don't have to do both. So if you are planning to if you are using this particular expression, you just fold the impulse response, shift the impulse response, and then multiply and integrate, right? Or if you are following the expression minus infinity to infinity x of t minus tau h of tau, then what do? You fold the x of t, you shift x of t, you use this multiplication and you integrate. Similarly for this side, here whatever I am saying for the continuous time applies for the discrete time also. Okay, so now let's do a problem so you will get a better hang of things. Okay, so x of t is equal to 0 for t less than 0, e of minus t for 0 less than or equal to t less than or equal to 1, and 0 for t greater than 1. Okay, h of t is equal to e to the power t by 2 ut. Find this is the question. Okay, first of all, let's see or visualize how these signals look. So x of t is it is only non-zero between 0 and 1, everywhere else it is 0, and between 0 and 1 it is a decaying exponential, right? So it will be something like this. This is x of, I am right away using the tau variable. Okay, and how will h of t look? H of t is a growing exponential, e to the power of my t by 2 multiplied by u of t, that is it will be 0 for t less than 0. So it will be something like this, and I am putting one here, 0, and I am using the what? I am using the tau variable here. Now what I am doing is I am going to fold. What happens if I fold now? It means I am flipping it. Right, 1 h of minus tau. Right. Now I am shifting it. Okay, let this be t, 0 h of t minus tau. Okay, so Here this t minus tau is h of minus of tau minus t. Okay, so the shift is rightwards only or in positive time. So this t is a variable, right? If t is 1, maybe it will be somewhere here, or if t is 5, it is somewhere here. So that is, we by changing the value of t, we can adjust how much further this h of t minus tau is coming. If t is equal to 0, then it is simply h of minus tau, right? And that is, by changing this t, you can basically, you can slide this signal from, so whatever, if t is negative, it means it will go in somewhere here, right? So basically by changing the value of t, you are shifting the, or you are changing the shift, you are sliding this, you can think of it like this, yeah, sliding this, right? Once you are at this point, and this is our signal. Now what do we have to do? We have to multiply and integrate. And the thing with multiplication is that, I hope you remember from our previous discussions. Okay, let me just draw this. This is our, will this be our x of t? Okay, and let me just draw it with another color. Okay, let this be our h of t minus tau, and this be our x of tau. Okay, I'm just overlapping them, 0, t, 1. The thing is, if t is less than 0, that is for this region, there is no overlapping between h of t minus tau and x of tau, right? Therefore, the product is 0. And if the product is 0, the summation or integral of the product is also 0. So you can right away write that for t less than 0, right, for t less than 0, x of t convolution h of t is equal to 0. Okay. Now, from 0 to 1, right, for the value of t from 0 to 1, it is not a fixed value, right? It is a different value here, it is a different value here, it is a different value here. So basically, we will have to keep t as a variable here, because it is a variable every time. So here we have to keep t as a variable. Because we are evaluating the integral for this whole area, we have to keep it as a variable. So for 0 less than or equal to t less than or equal to 1, we have, what do we have? X of t convolution h of t is equal to integral, right? Integral what? 0 to t. The value of tau. Here t is a variable. The value of tau is from 0 to t, right? Because as we are sliding this h of t minus tau from 0 to 1, right? The integral, the effective area that we are getting, the effective area is from 0 to t only, right? The t may be at 0.1 or 1 or 0.75 or whatever, but the effective area is from only 0 to t, the value of tau. Okay, so this is minus e to the power of minus tau into e to the power of t minus tau by 2 d tau. So this is x of tau and this is h of t minus tau. Now you have to evaluate this particular integral, right? And we can take this t by 2 outside, e to the power of t by 2 outside, because it is a constant and because the variable of integration is tau. So we have e to the power of t by 2 integral 0 to t, right? Integral 0 to t e to the power of minus 3 by 2 tau and d. So you can integrate this. Ultimately what you will get is what, e to the power of t by 2 e to the power of minus 3 t tau by 2 by minus 3 by 2 from 0 to t, which when finally after the calculations you will get something like 2 by 3 e to the power of t by 2 into 1 minus e to the power of minus 3 by 2 t. Okay, this is some form. You can keep it in different forms if you want. Now for the third region, now what happens if t is greater than 1? That is, if t is greater than 1, our signal will be somewhere here, right? T will be somewhere here. So here what is happening here, this, no matter what is the value of t, the area of overlapping will be only between 0 and 1. It doesn't change whether t is from at 1.1 or infinity, because in all these area after tau is greater than 1, the value of x of tau is 0. So no matter what value you go, doesn't matter, the area of overlap is between 0 and 1, and that value is a constant, right? That area is a constant. There's no variable like here the area of overlap was changing. That means the integral was changing and you had to put the integral from 0 to 1, but from for t greater than 1 it is not the case, right? For t greater than 1, what is the thing? For t greater than 1, it is not like that. It is a constant. So for t greater than 1, x of t convolution h of t is equal to 0 to 1 integral e to the power of minus tau t minus tau by 2 d tau. So here also, what do we do? We can take this t by 2 outside, integral 0 to 1 to the power of minus t by 2 tau d tau, which is equal to, what is it, e to the power of t by 2, sorry, not minus, e to the power of t by 2 e to the power of minus 3 tau by 2 by minus 3 by 2 from 0 to 1. So ultimately you will get something like 2 by 3 e to the power of t by 2 1 minus e to the power of minus 3 by 2. Similar to this, but that variable is not present. Okay, so now you have got the three different areas, the integral values for, or the convolution values for different areas. So how do we finally write it down? So x of t convolution h of t is equal to 0 for t less than 0, is equal to 2 by 3 e to the power of 0.5 t, or t by 2, 1 minus e to the power of minus 1.5 t for 0 less than or equal to t less than or equal to 1, equal to 2 by 3 e to the power of 0.5 t 1 minus e to the power of minus 1.5 t for t greater than 1. Okay, so this is the final answer. You can draw it if you want, but sometimes it is a little bit cumbersome to visualize all, because this is not there, sorry, t is not there. Sometimes it is easy because this will be just a simple exponential t by 2 with some constant multiplied, but this may not be that much easy to visualize. Anyway, a mathematical expression will suffice. So I just want to sum it up. So basically we have our x of t or x of tau, and we had our h of tau, then we folded it, shifted it, right, folded it, shifted it, and then what did we do? We checked for areas of overlap. Okay, we checked for areas. This is h of t minus tau. This is x of tau. Okay, then we were trying to identify different regions to integrate. Okay, so out of that, from and this was t 0 1 and this is tau only. Okay, so we identified three regions. Okay, depending on the values of both x and h. So this was from t less than 0. What was the significance of this? There was no area of overlap between these two, because one, we are finding integral means what are we doing? We are finding the area. And what are we finding the integral of? We are finding the integral of product of two signals, right? We are finding the integral of product of two signals means for a product of two signals to be having a non-zero value, there should be some area of overlap, some region of overlap, right? So here it is not there. So here t is, for t less than 0, there is nothing. It is h of the response will be 0. And for t greater than 1, what is happening? We are sliding this from t is equal to minus infinity to infinity, right? We're sliding this from t equal to minus infinity to infinity, and we are looking, okay, what are the different possible values for each region. So once we cross t greater than 0, then no matter where you go in this region, the area of overlap is a constant, right? That is why we took the integration from 0 to 1. And within this region, that is 0 less than or equal to t less than or equal to 1, what is happening? The area of, this is the crucial part, identifying this is important. Okay, the area of overlap depends on the value of t, because the area of overlap is always from 0 to t. And remember, we are always keeping on sliding this h of t, right? Depending on the value of t, the variable t, it changes. We are sliding it, basically. So it depends on 0 to t. That is why we took the integral from 0 to t here, 0 to 1 here, and there is no value here. So that is regarding the convolution integral. I'll put out some problems for doing convolution integral for some practice problems, and also we need to take a look at how to do convolution sum, right? That convolution sum I'll discuss in the next lecture. Along with that, we'll do some shortcuts and things like that. Some extra topic is there regarding the convolution. But the thing is that once you are strong with this, the concept of this changing this basic steps, you can say, once you are strong with these steps, how do you shift and things like that, then convolution is pretty much easy, and it depends on how much problems you do. So we'll see you in the next lecture. Thank you.